Are you suffering from solving a system of linear equations? Here, I have three linear equations with three unknowns, x1, x2, x3 in each equation, and I will show you how to solve it using Gauss Jordan elimination. Before you solve the system of linear equations, I'm gonna briefly explain what I mean by solving the system of linear equations. The main issue of the system of linear equation is we have multiple unknowns in each equation. To solve them, we need to eliminate the unknowns from each equation except only one. In other words, we need to eliminate x2, x3 from the first equation, x1, x3 from the second equation, x1 and x2 from the third equation, so we can solve it for x1, x2, x3 easily. In this case, I arbitrarily use A, B, and C for solutions. The Gauss Jordan elimination is an algorithm to systematically eliminate the unknowns from each equation. To use Gauss Jordan elimination, the first step is to build augmented matrix from the systems of linear equations. The elements of the augmented matrix is nothing more than collection of coefficients and numbers in the equations. First, coefficients are the numbers sitting in front of unknowns. If you do not find any, it means you have one. Secondly, we need the numbers on the right-hand side. Here, we have 12, 6, and 1. For the augmented matrix, we create two-dimensional array of elements having coefficients and the numbers. We also use vertical bar to represent equal signs. Actually, this augmented matrix is an equivalent to the systems of linear equations above. Next, we reduce the augmented matrix to a reduced echelon form using Gauss Jordan elimination. The reduced row echelon form is an identity matrix on left side and certain numbers on right. Here, we use A, B, C as an example. The reduced row echelon form is equivalent to the simple equations above. So your solutions are x1 equals A, x2 equals B, and x3 equals C. Again, my ultimate goal is to reduce the augmented matrix to reduced row echelon form. My suggested sequence is in the followings. First, reduce first row first column element to 1. Second, reduce second row first column element to 0. Third, reduce second row second column element to 1. Fourth and fifth, reduce the third row first two column elements to zeros. Sixth, reduce third row third column elements to 1. Seventh, eighth, and ninth, reduce remaining elements to zeros. The suggested sequence is a kind of counterclockwise direction from 1 to 9. The question comes how to reduce the augmented matrix. We use elementary row operation, and these are row-wise operations since each row represents linear equation. First elementary row operation is a row multiplying operation. Typically, we use to reduce the diagonal elements to ones by dividing each row with diagonal elements. Making diagonal elements ones is important since we will use this element as a pivot point to eliminate off-diagonal elements by making them zeros. Second one is a row adding operation. Typically, we use it to reduce the off-diagonal elements to zeros by subtracting from each other. Making zeros of off-diagonal elements means we decouple unknowns from each equation. I will show you the step-by-step approach for Gauss Jordan elimination. I label each row as a R1, R2, and R3 to represent first, second, and third rows. My first step is to reduce the element in the first row, first column 1. When you reduce diagonal elements to ones, you simply use the row multiplying operation. You can simply take the magnitude of the diagonal element and divide entire elements in the first row. Since I have 2, I will divide all the elements in the first row by 2. As a result, my new elements in the first row becomes 1, minus 1, and 2, and 6. I keep all the elements in the second and third rows the same. Again, you successfully made your elements in the first row and the first column 1. Next step is to reduce the element in the second row and the first column to 0. To make the off-diagonal elements 0, you use 1 in the diagonal element in the same column as a pivot point, then make it 0 by using the row adding operation. Since I have 1 in the second row, first column, I subtract first row from the second row by element. So my new second row becomes 0 since I have 1 minus 1, 2 since I have 1 minus 1, 1 since I have 3 minus 2, and 0 since I have 6 minus 6. I keep all the elements in the first and third rows the same. So you successfully made 0 in the second row and the first column. Next step is to make my 2 1. Since I have 2, I will use the row multiplying operation. Simply, I divide each element in the second row by 2. As a result, the new elements will be 0, 1, and 1 half, and 0. I keep all the elements in the first and third rows the same. So you successfully reduce 2 to 1. Next step is to reduce my minus 1 to 0. I will use 1 in the first row and the first column as a pivot point. Since I have minus 1, I will add first row to third row by element by element. My first 0 comes from minus 1 plus 1, my 1 comes from 2 minus 1, and my 4 comes from 2 plus 2, my 7 comes from 1 plus 6. I keep all the elements in the first two rows the same. So you successfully made 0 in the third row and the first column. Next step is to reduce my 1 to 0. I will use 1 in the second row and second column as a pivot point. Since I have 1, I will subtract second row from the third row by element by element. My first 0 comes from 0 minus 0, and my 0 comes from 1 minus 1, and my 7 over 2 comes from 4 minus 1 half, and my 7 comes from 7 minus 0. I keep all the elements in the first two rows the same, so you successfully made 0 in the third row and second column. My next step is to make my 7 half 1. Since I have 7 half, I will multiply 2 over 7 on each element in the third row. And the new elements will be 0, 0, 1, and 2. I keep all the elements in the first two rows the same. So you successfully reduce 7 over 2 to 1. Next step is to reduce my 1 half to 0. I will use 1 in the third row, third column as a pivot point. Since I have 1 half, I will multiply 1 half on R3 and subtract from second row by element by element. My first 0 comes from 0 minus 0, and my 1 comes from 1 minus 0, and my 0 comes from 1 half minus 1 half, and my minus 1 comes from 0 minus 1. So you successfully made 0 in the second row and third column. Next step is to reduce my 2 to 0. I will use 1 in the third row and third column as a pivot point. Since I have 2, I will multiply 2 on R3 and subtract from first row element by element. My 1 comes from 1 minus 0, my minus 1 comes from minus 1 minus 0, and my 0 comes from 2 minus 2, my 2 comes from 6 minus 4. I keep all the elements in the last two rows the same, so you successfully made 0 in the first row and third column. Next step is to reduce my minus 1 to 0. I will use 1 in the second row and second column as a pivot point. Since I have minus 1, I will add R1 to R2 by element by element. My first 1 comes from 1 minus 0, and my 0 comes from minus 1 plus 0. My 0 comes from minus 1 plus 1, and my 0 comes from 0 plus 0. My 1 comes from 2 minus 1. I kept all the elements in the last two rows the same. So you successfully made 0 in the first row, second column. Congratulations! You successfully reached the reduced row echelon form. Probably this is the most enjoyable part. You can simply read off the numbers on the right side of the vertical bar as a solution, which is x1 equals 1, x2 equals minus 1, x3 equals 2. To ensure you got the right solution, you can plug them into the systems of linear equation. If you have 12 from first equation, 6 from the second equation, and 1 from the third equation, your calculation were perfect. You can also check your final solutions by using built-in function called RREF in Octave or MATLAB. The RREF functions returns the reduced row echelon form of augmented matrix. First, you need to create the augmented A and B and then use it as an input for RREF function. The result is the same as what you got from the previous slide, so you are good. In summary, I hope you understand better how to solve the systems of linear equation with the three unknowns using Gauss Jordan elimination.
Thanks for watching this video, and please subscribe my channel if you haven't done it yet. thumbs up if you enjoyed. Please feel free to share your thoughts in the comment section below. See you next time.